Hi. Okay, so today we're going to look at some of the hype books I'm going to read in the future. I'm sure you'll agree with me when I say how hard it is to find a good book these days, because some really amazing books remain underrated, while novels which can single-handedly set this world years back are hyped like they are masterpieces of this generation. If these novels are the masterpieces, then I don't think we have got any reason to live anymore. Anywho, these are some of the books I'm going to read in the future, and let's hope that at least 3 or 4 of them are worth my time. Red, White, and Royal Blue. This novel has been all over the Instagram. Almost every second account has a picture clicked of this novel. Now, I don't know whether they are doing this just because everyone is doing it, or whether they actually like this book. What I read about this book is that it has sort of a royal presidential setting. You know what? Just imagine the setting of what a girl wants. It's got that fake friendship thing, if you're into stuff like that. This novel keeps getting interesting, right? I couldn't even bear to read the summary of this novel. I read the setting and I was like, I like to surprise myself by not knowing anything about this novel. So I'm totally clueless about this novel. One thing which I genuinely find interesting about this novel is that this is not your typical a girl falling in love with a boy novel. This is actually the reason why I'm even considering reading this novel. Good approach. I respect the author for this decision already. The second novel is Beach Read. This book is everywhere. You can't escape from it. This one is actually quite interesting. Just kidding. It's also full of cliches that we've heard countless times. Basically, there are two writers who are working on a deadline, and they are totally different from each other. They get to know each other, and my bet is they end up together. But I would like to be surprised. The hating game. This is also kind of like the beach read. The main characters hate each other. Oh, really? They hate each other. Okay, now there is no way for them to get together. I mean, we know how romance novels end up. Characters who hate each other, they never end up together. They hate each other, right? They're not going to get together. No way. Not a chance. Anyways, they are opponents and they keep on trying to undermine each other. Don't want to sound judgmental, but they have way too much free time. So you got that they hate each other, and then they start to feel things they haven't felt before. Oh yeah, well, this book has got some really original ideas, I must say. But let's hope that this novel is somewhat worth our time. Fangirl. Actually, this book has been talked about a lot, so I finally decided that I'm going to read it. It's about Kath, who is a fan of Simon Snow. I don't know why whenever I hear the name Simon, it makes me think of a cat. But anyways, this novel focuses on Kath and her journey to get over her Simon obsession. I don't know, it's not the typical romance novel. Still, I'm not sure what to say about this novel. It's got a different plot, but let's see if I like it. The Hate You Give. Okay, for this novel, I'm just going to read straight from the source. 16-year-old Star Carter moves between two worlds, the poor neighborhood where she lives and the fancy suburban prep school she attends. The uneasy balance between these worlds is shattered when Star witnesses the fatal shooting of her childhood friend Khalil at the hands of a police officer. Khalil was unarmed. Soon afterward, his death is a national headline. Some are calling him a thug, maybe even a drug dealer and a gangbanger. Protesters are taking to the streets in Khalil's name. Some cops and the local drug lord try to intimidate Star and her family. What everyone wants to know is what really went down that night. And the only person alive who can answer that is a Star. But what Star does or does not say could upend her community. It can also endanger her life. Yeah. So basically, this novel is based on the Black Lives Matter movement. Now, I hope that this novel is good, because I hate all those people who think that racism is justified. Racism is really immature. I mean, it's all about your genes. You don't have to hurt innocent people. So, I wish that this novel portrays that incident well, because this novel might matter in the future too, if it's good enough. Let's see. And from the past incidents, it is evident that me having high expectations from contemporary novels ends in disappointment. Pretty Reckless, for example. I'm not going to get into that. Just check out this video. Anyways, The Hate U Give is a different novel than Pretty Reckless. So there's no comparison really. The Hate U Give can actually be a great novel. Now, let's see. The sixth book is A Little Life. This novel is actually something I'm willing to read with all my heart. I don't know why I like books which makes me feel sad, strange, but I like the vibes of this book. It's about four classmates who moved to New York for college. They have no money, but they have each other, and they have their ambitions. So, four of them are doing their own thing, and Jude is the glue that holds this group together. As the years go by, it is revealed that Jude is a broken man, and he had a traumatic childhood. This novel also analyzes the friendship of these four characters, which is a very interesting thing according to me. I'm really looking forward to reading this book. I think I will start reading this book first. I have a feeling that I might actually like this book. Now, the last book is Ready Player One. This is a dystopian novel. I actually want this novel to be good. I don't like reading romances, and that's why I feel that this book must be on the list so that I don't lose my equilibrium. So basically, this novel is like The Hunger Games. It's set in the year 2044. And Wade Watts is on his search for an Easter egg in a virtual reality game. The discovery will get him the creator's fortune. Never read a novel like this, so I'll see if I can actually appreciate it. Hi guys, how are you all? Hope you're doing well. There are a lot of books that are really popular, and some of them are extremely good. But normally, I don't like hyped books, because they are believed to be the masterpieces of our generation. But I don't find anything new or sensible in those novels. Still, there are some novels which are brilliant. I'm talking about Norwegian Wood. I heard a lot about Murakami books, but I never read them. And I can see why Norwegian Wood is so famous. I just love the simplicity of that novel. That's why I feel that the fame it gets is totally justified. A question to you though. Which popular book are you planning to read and why?
But anyway, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe. Don't forget to ring that bell so you don't miss any videos from me. Follow me on Instagram. Let me know what was your favorite part of the video or which novel I should review next. Or just say hi, that's fine too. And above all that, everybody have an amazing day. I'll see you all next Monday.